Let us now discuss about some important points about mutual induction. The very first point about mutual induction we can write is that M is a bidirectional coefficient for a pair of coils. Like say we are given with a pair of two coils, 1 and 2. Then we can say if in the first coil a current I1 is flowing, some flux phi2 will be linked with the second coil, and here phi2 we can write as MI1. It's vice versa is also true, like for the same pair of coils, 1 and 2, if a current I2 starts flowing in the second coil, a flux phi1 will be linked due to I2, and here phi1 we can write as MI2. Like here, if a current I1 is flowing, flux linked with the second coil will be M times I1. And similarly, if I2 is the current flowing in second coil, flux linked with the first coil will be due to current I2 will be MI2. That's why we call it a bidirectional coefficient. It is defined for the pair and it can be applied in either direction, either for calculation of flux in second coil due to current in first coil, or for calculation of flux in first coil due to current in second coil. So always remember about it. Similarly, sometimes we are required to understand one more phenomena. If a current flows in both the coils, then what will happen? We can write, if a current flows, currents flow in both coils, then we can find flux in each coil by using both self and mutual induction. Like say, if this is the situation, when we can say we are given with two coils in which currents flowing are I1 and I2. Here we are given that for the pair of coils, the coefficient of mutual induction is M, and for the two independent coils, the coefficient of self-inductions are L1 and L2 respectively. Then we can say flux linked in coil 1, this coil 1, this 2, this phi1 we can write, due to current I1, a flux will be linked with itself, which can be written as L1 I1. And due to current I2, a flux will also be passing through the first coil. That depends on the orientation of these turns. It could be in the same direction as that of current of flux of I1, or it may be opposite. So we can write the flux due to second coil is also passing through the first coil. This can be written as plus minus of MI2. Here very carefully understand why I have taken both plus and minus, because say if current I1 produces a magnetic field in L1 in this direction, and due to current I2 the magnetic field is also in same direction, it will be added. But if it is in opposite direction, it will be subtracted. So total flux will be less than that of only due to I1. And the direction of magnetic field will depend on the turns, whether these are clockwise or these are anti-clockwise. That also we'll discuss how we can represent it on paper. But let's first conclude it that the total flux linked with the first coil will be given by L1 I1. And additional flux through it due to the second coil will be MI2, and it can be either in same direction or in opposite direction. Similarly, we can calculate flux linked in coil 2. This is phi2, and here phi2 we can write a flux due to its own current, which is L2 I2, again plus minus MI1. Because due to current I1, some flux will be there in the second coil, which may be in the same direction or in opposite direction, which is given as MI. So this is the way how we calculate the total magnetic flux through coils if current is flowing in both the coils. Let's continue on the next sheet for a diagrammatic representation of orientation of turns in an inductor. In continuation, let's discuss the dot convention for inductors for defining magnetic poles. As a standard, dot convention is defined for various situations, like for EMF induced, polarity of EMF induced, or defining magnetic poles. Here we are discussing about representation of magnetic poles in an inductor when current flows through it by using a dot convention. Like say we are given with an inductor having self-induction coefficient L and a current is passing through it from left to right. On paper here we cannot state whether magnetic induction in it is from left to right or from right to left. That depends on the winding of these turns. If it is clockwise as seen from right, the magnetic induction will be left. If it is anti-clockwise, it is toward right. Just to denote the direction of magnetic induction, we put a dot on either side of the inductor. Wherever we put the dot, we consider this end as north pole of the inductor as a short magnet and the other end we consider as a south pole. This is the convention I am going to use in the coming sections. Whereas in different texts, dot convention may be given in a different way. Now in this situation, if dot is placed on the right side of inductor, we can see that the magnetic induction in it or the magnetic flux in the inductor will exist from left to right. And similarly, if in an inductor a dot is placed on the left hand side, we can say its flux phi will be from right to left, and this end will act as a north pole, this will act as a south pole, no matter from whichever direction the current is flowing in the inductor. Or we can simply state that dot is defining here the orientation of turns in the inductor, how the turns are oriented due to which the magnetic induction is produced within the inductor. Now the advantage of this is if say we are given two inductors placed close to each other, in which the currents are flowing I1 and I2 like this, then here we can state if this is L1, this is L2 and the mutual induction for these two pair of coils, these two coils is M. Then we can state if the dots are on opposite sides of the inductor, flux in the first coil phi1 we can write as L1 I1. Minus MI2, because we can see the flux due to I1 in this inductor phi1 will be from left to right, and in the other coil due to I2 it is from right to left. So both the flux will oppose each other. So phi1 is L1 I1 minus MI2, and phi2 we can write as L2 I2 minus MI1. Similarly, if a pair of inductor is given in such a way that dots are drawn on the same sides of the inductor which are having self inductions L1 and L2, and if say currents I1 and I2 are flowing in the two inductors, then we can see in both the flux produced by the own current will be in same direction. So we can write total value of phi1 is due to its own current and due to the current by the other, where again the mutual induction for this pair of coil is M. So here we can write it L1 I1 plus M I2, and phi2 we can write as L2 I2 plus M I1. This is the way how dot convention helps us to define the direction of magnetic induction or magnetic flux in an inductor.